hey guys, this is going to be another hopefully one-shot video. It's really late, like actually it's after midnight already, whoops. But I haven't gone to bed yet, so it still technically counts as the 21st, right? 21st day of Veda. Today I'm going to do a book review. I'm going to do A Monster Calls, and it is by Patrick Ness, with illustrations by Jim Kay, and it's based on an idea by Siobhan Dowd. It's a great book, but first of all, the plot. The plot is about Connor. Connor is a teenage boy, and he is struggling to deal with his mom, who is ill. She has cancer. At least, I don't know if they ever actually say in the book that it's cancer. I think they do. It's very much implied that it's cancer anyway. But so he's dealing with this. She's, you know, very, very ill in the book, and he is kind of working through this. He's also dealing with how people are treating him differently because of his mom's illness, and the way that his relationship with his dad and the relationship that he has with his grandma, how those are evolving as well. Due to his mom's illness. And the whole book, obviously, is about that. Oh, and by the way, it is called A Monster Calls, and there is a monster in the book, and the monster does call on him repeatedly and tells him stories. I loved this book. I don't even think that's a strong enough word. I adored this book. It was just beyond wonderful. It was so good. I mean, I had no expectations when I went into this book. I bought it on a total whim. I was just at the bookstore trying to find a book because I left my book that I was reading at home, and I wanted to take my kid to the park, and I don't like to go to the park without a book because otherwise I'm just like staring at the kids. And maybe some people like that. I like to read at the park, and so I went and bought a book, and this was the book. The cover just like jumped out at me. Look at it. That is a striking cover. And I had to get it. And the illustrations are gorgeous. They're absolutely beautiful. I'll show you my favorite one. I marked it so that I could find it easily. This is my favorite illustration in the whole book. And they're all like this. They're all really good, really great illustrations. This book is just it's beautifully painful. It's terrifyingly sad. Just more moving than any book I can remember reading in recent history. Like, I can't remember the last time a book has, like, spoke to me on such an emotional level. I probably cried for an hour after I finished this book. Yeah, it was that, it was that strong. I will definitely give this book 5 out of 5 stars. I 100% recommend this book to everyone, except my mother, who doesn't like sad books. And if you don't like sad books, if you are one of those happy-go-lucky people who just, you just want to read books with happy endings, and that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. Just don't read this book. but if you are in the mood for something really powerful and really moving, something really profound that's definitely going to make you think and question and just, I don't know, just so... It's so good. It just, I'm feeling chills and I'm feeling like I could cry right now because I am remembering how good this book is. Anyway, that is my review. Like I said, highly recommend it. Definitely read it if you haven't read it. I know it's been out for a couple of years already, I think. I'm not sure exactly when this book was published. 2011. So yeah, 2 years roughly that this book has been out. But yeah, highly recommended. And that is the end of my review. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye.